So what's the comprehensive step? What's the comprehensive steps taken by the government to enhance the development of human capital within the aviation and the MRO sector, particularly through collaborative efforts with industry stakeholders, including MRO players, OEMs, and other manufacturers? How is the government working to create an effective education and training curriculum to equip engineers and support staff with necessary skills, and what measures are being implemented to incentivize careers in MRO through scholarship and student exchange program and other benefits? And how does our country leverage its strength for the engineering workforce to competitive labor cost, to attract global MRO activities, and to bolster our position in India? And are you considering airfields which are available for MROs in around India, for MRO setups in north, south, west, and east, such like Rajasthan and Jalalabad and Bara and other places in Rajasthan, to have the MRO structures in our country?
Thank you. Honorable Speaker, sir, we understand that if we want to improve the MRO sector in the country, it is not just about creating the infrastructure, but also skilling it with the right amount of talent pool from the country also. And the government has taken several initiatives regarding this, sir. Government has already set up a policy under Civil Aviation Requirements 147, training by MROs for up to 200 aircraft maintenance engineering schools, which are imparting 300 hours of practical training for mechanics to bridge the gap between supply and demand. Also for AMEs, which are the aircraft maintenance engineers, which do the line maintenance in the airports, which is the basic level of maintenance, sir. We have 57 schools which are imparting this education. And type certification of AMEs also, where there is specifically done for different kinds of aircraft. So we are ensuring that right amount of skilling is also done in the country so that there is no skill gap at all. If you consider the number of AMEs, aircraft maintenance engineers, the country today has the potential to produce up to 3,700 every year. And the pool that we have right now is 16,000 right now, sir. And it is more than adequate that we have. And we are, like I said, we are having at least 100 planes that are added to our fleet every year because of the orders up to 1,150 that we have. So we recognize that there is going to be a lot of demand in the coming years also. And we are ensuring that we are partnering up with the Airbus, Boeing and other industry players, other original equipment manufacturers also. We are bringing them on board. We are ensuring that the right amount of technical competence is brought in so that the courses which is required for skilling is done in our country. And also the last part of his question where he said that, are you looking at Rajasthan and all that? Specifically in Rajasthan, we have two MROs right now, sir, and which is Himalayan Heli Services, which is near Jaipur, and also Aviana Aviation Private, which is near Kishangarh, Ajmer. And regarding the MROs, setting up of MROs anywhere in the country, the Airports Authority of India, which is under central government, it has taken out all the royalties that are required for setting up of MROs so that it eases the process. We have given a card rate right now. So anyone who wants to set up an MRO anywhere in the country, let it be an airstrip, let it be an airport, anywhere, we'll follow due diligence, and we want to encourage MROs more and more from our government side. So definitely, if there is any proposal from anywhere in the country, even if it is the remotest part of the country, if there is an airport, if there is an airstrip, we will provide the necessary assistance and ensure the MRO facility is there. That much I can say from this.
Maniya Mantri ji ne bahut acha aur bada vistrit uttar de diya hai. Ye lagta nahi koi sab acha jawab diya hai na.